partner of swimming.
Welcome back to Barcelona and to live coverage here in Port Vell from the first round of the first ever Women's World Championship high diving. It's not from the 27 metres that we saw from the men. This goes down to 20 metres, but we will see very similar dives and a very similar degree of difficulty. So the divers up on the platform, just about to be presented. I can tell you that since yesterday in the men's competition, the wind has picked up a little bit. There's your start list. We have six divers going in this first World Championships. They will dive across three rounds, and as the first two rounds are decided, then we will move into a redraw for the third and final round, when they will bring out their big dives to score maximum points. Watch out for Cecily Carlton of the USA. A lot of people tipping her for success, the 32-year-old American, but USA have two other very experienced athletes in Tierra Hayatera of the USA and veteran 38-year-old Ginger Hoover. Well, there is Cecily Carlton in your picture. All of these competitors today, former gymnasts, former and current acrobats, and most have dived at collegiate or international level as well in the pool. So quite a few of these names you would have seen over the years in various competitions. So Cecily Carlton takes the plaudits of the crowd, and there's plenty of those because once again it's packed here at Port Vell. So Tara Hayatera, but likes to be called Tara, and she is known, Chris, as Twinkle Toes.
Yes, she is. Apparently, when the divers get aches, she does the massage, but with her toes on their back and shoulders, and so she's got the name as Twinkle Toes.
Now, another potential gold medal favourite, Anna Bader of Germany. A solid competitor, six-time European cliff diving champion. You don't come to a World Championships with that kind of pedigree and not expect to be on the podium. For the USA, one of the most experienced high divers in the world, Ginger Hoover, SeaWorld employee based in San Diego, but has been diving for many years now. Diana Tomalina is easily the least experienced in this competition, and all accounts are that her training has not been going too well in Barcelona, but she's been gradually improving. And then finally, Stephanie De Lima from Quebec, originally coached by Cesar Henderson, who we see by the poolside with the Canadian team, has moved into the world of high diving, but is an acrobat by profession, started in the high diving world back in 2007, but a lot of these athletes really only recently moving up a gear, because it is only in the last year that the Women's World Series has been put together. So this is very new for these divers, and a lot of these names still looking to really establish themselves at this level. It's not just the whole surfy feel to the high diving community, but you can see it's quite relaxed as well for the judges down there on the boat.
Yeah, I've been to a different series, and it's a fantastic atmosphere, not so formal. And the crowd it pulls, 70,000 in France, 30,000 in Boston. It is really popular, and we've seen hundreds and even thousands of boats come, you know, slowly in as they see that the high diving is on those world circuits.
And all run by Nikki Stajkovic, doing a fantastic job.
Yeah, Nikki Stajkovic from Austria, lives in Hawaii, five-time Olympic diver for Austria, and I dove against him three of those Olympics, and crazy man.
Round one of three about to get underway for our six divers involved in this first ever FINA World High Diving Championship. Off the 20-metre board at Port Vell in Barcelona, it's Cecily Carlton, 32 years of age from the USA, that will lead things away. Most of the divers on the high diving scene has what you describe as gymnastic proportions, so Cecily is completely typical. 5 feet 4 inches tall, which is 1 meter 62, 53 kilograms, and you need that for the multiple spins and rotations. Slightly taller divers, not as easy. So relatively straightforward dive first round, no hanging about at all from Carlton. She won't be pleased with that entry.
Right, three divers in this round will be doing this dive. It's a forward double somersault half twist. The dives are slightly easier because of the low height, and it carries a 2.6 degree of difficulty. Average scores to start, 54.6.
Yeah, Carlton would have liked something a little bit tidier than that. Certainly the entry was a problem. It's all three Americans that are doing this same dive.
Yeah, typical of them. There's a problem on the start, jumping too far forward. And we just see she slightly overcooks it on the end, just going over from vertical, and the marks have shown that. There's the lean forward, the 1.5. Now we see the Barani out. That's performed really well. Just picking up too much speed here, though, and she can't stop it from going over. Good flight out, but because of that start, anytime you lean away from the platform, we saw it in the 10-meter competition, you can't control your entry. This is feet first, they were head first, but it is same mechanics still working.
Again, some incredible slow motion replays coming to us from this World Championships. And remember, these first two rounds are relatively easy dives on a suppressed tariff. It's the last round where you'll see them pull out their big showpiece dive and go for the points. So USA first and second to start off this opening round. Twinkle Toes next. Tira Hayatira of the USA, 27 years of age. All five brothers dive to collegiate level, so she said she's had plenty of chance to watch how diving is done before she came into the world of diving. 4 years with the University of Notre Dame. Notre Dame, if we're going to split
the American way, yeah.
So, first dive for the second of three Americans in this final. Same dive as we saw from Cecily Carlton for Tira. Again, just that little arm movement in the air, but the entry itself was superb.
Yeah, she got around vertical. Same problem, just that lean away from the platform, so the judges aren't seeing the confident jump up in the air. And I'm just wondering if the height and the wind is affecting her. But I think she'll pull out good scores because it was a vertical entry. Definitely should score more than Colton.
Not just 62.4, but you're right, Chris. That cross, well, it's more than a breeze now. That crosswind is going to affect the athletes today. A solid start.
Yeah, she's pleased with that. She's now relaxed, but they're leaning forward, not finishing particularly high, and you can see the arms moving around. I think she was just out too early, and she feels the wobble here coming around into the Barani. Tries to make the adjustment with her arm. Yeah, just not that confident on the jump. Better to have a springy jump, you have a little bit more control, but a good finish.
So next to the ball will be the German, Anna Bader. Bader, as I said, six-time European cliff diving champion. She also managed to finish third in a European men's event back in 2012, the Lady of the Lake. Looking to continue her great start, picking up the first ever World Series event medal.
This is a beautiful dive if she gets it right. It's the first arm stand we're going to see. And it's straight all the way throughout, so she needs to just judge the rotation. It's a back arm stand, 1.5 somersaults in a straight position.
And you only just got there, so goodness me, it's going to be tough for Anna.
Yeah, I was just trying to work out where is she going to spot this, but if she does it right, it just sort of flows.
And the divers, as you said, not under pressure to get out to the end of the board. This is all about making sure they work in their own time frame. They are dealing with something that is potentially incredibly dangerous, which is why the judges give that little bit of space for the divers just to set themselves upright. So then, Germany will begin their challenge at this first high diving World Championships. Just making making sure that judges are happy, making sure the safety divers are in place. And as Chris Snowd said, arm stand dive, but just watch what happens after she leaves the platform. This really is an unbelievable dive to watch if she gets it right.
Yeah, this is the tricky part. Straddling up. Boy, she's strong, isn't she?
That crosswind really buffeting her, but she's staying nice and solid, nice and straight. Good arm stand. Beautiful, absolutely beautiful. Disappears on that one, and the divers go underneath very quickly because she would have gone a long way down after that dive into this harbour.
That's right. They scooched straight down behind her. Yeah, it was just about spot on. Great handstand, showed the control even with the wind. It'll be a big score.
It should be a good one then for Anna Varda to get things underway. It is eight and a halfs for 65. I think the judges will keep their powder just a little bit dry through the course of this first round, but that is a super solid start from Varda.
Yeah, look how strong she is. And just has to push the right amount off of those wrists. That's good. And look at the layout position. Reaching back, seeing the water, holding it there just long enough. Pretty good dive. Small pike just as she came off. I like that position. And just a hair short of vertical. Yeah, just a little bend just there. And then out into the arch. Good spot position. And you really feel like you're flying at this point. It's a beautiful feeling. And now you are accelerating incredibly fast. You don't have that much time to put your hands against your legs and lock out your body.
Yeah, statistics say that the high divers accelerate faster than a sports car, up to 85 kilometers per hour when they eventually hit the water. They're not quite traveling as fast, 7 meters less their platform height. Now, Ginger Hoover, when you talk about experience in this sport, then this woman has it all. Started back in 1998, dived at the University of Georgia, 93 to 97, and states that she loves that iconic spot that we all associate with high diving, Acapulco in Mexico.
Yeah, I've seen Ginger dive lots and lots, 17 years experience. I've also seen her on the Russian swing, and she is a bungee expert down at SeaWorld in California.
Well, solid start, but again, not quite where she wanted to be in terms of the last phase of that dive.
Yeah, it's a front double, half, same as the other two Americans. Yeah, just talking about the pipe position at the end. I think she got there. I didn't like the arms moving around, though. I don't think she hasn't gone into the lead now. It's just a judge's not quite agreeing. Got a 7.5 and an 8.5. We'll see on the replay. There's a little problem with the arms coming out of the 1.5 section. And then she had about 14 meters to do the Brani, and the arms were moving around.
Similar score to the other two Americans. It is still Anna Varda that leads for Germany. You see, it's a very different rhythm to the whole sport than when we're in the pool.
Yeah, just as she comes around on the 1.5 somersaults, it's good at this point. And now, as she's coming around, she has to adjust the arms. The arms you see bend just a little bit there, and then stay slightly pike on the entry. Good flight through the air, nice drop at the end. Just the arms. You can just tell it's a small wobble. That's safe, though. She's spotting the water all the way throughout. Her body tension is really strong. It has to be on cliff diving and high diving. Just the arms a little out of position at this point before she brings them down to press against her body.
Well, they've been building this scaffold structure for the last couple of weeks here. Nikki Stajkovic, the program director for World High Diving, here are making sure that everything is just right. But this is a very new event for everybody concerned. And I think everybody wondering how things would work out. over the course of this week, but the build-up to the high diving has been immense. It's been the talk of the town, really, at these World Aquatic Championships. Now, time for the divers to deliver, and it's all looking very good at the moment. Now then, Diana Tomalina of Ukraine. This is the diver that has had a few issues in training with this whole setup, but, well, initial news wasn't so positive, Chris, but she has been improving in the last day of training.
Yeah, she's had a few crashes, and a coach just kept saying, go back up, go back up. This, though, is a reverse somersault in the pike position. The pike will happen very quickly. She's going to pike before she goes past the platform.
There we go, into the water safely. Not quite, again, as she would like to be, but that's fine from Tomalina, and she certainly is finding some form as the competition has started.
She certainly is getting better and better. But you saw the pike on the entry, and they're going to mark her down for it. Did like the start, but the entry is all important, and they have marked her down for it.
Yes, just 42.9, but very, very new to this sport. A couple of the big names from those initial World Series missing as well. So this really is just the start of what we hope is something that is going to grow and grow in the world of diving.
Now, I think that as she gets more confident, does a lot more of the competitions, and she increases her degree of difficulty for the optional dives, then she'll be one to watch.
Yes, and as Huber has already proved, another 4 years at least of this young lady to dive.
Yeah, you can dive well into your 30s. There you see the touch of the toes out quickly, looking back. She just needed to swing her arms faster. There's the pike at board level, floating around. She's now at 10 meters, 5 meters. And in just the angle of the entry, she works on that. That's a good position there. But she can just feel slightly too slow and doesn't pull the dive around. Oh, you saw the impact on the face then just as she hit. So the water caught her chin. And from above, we saw her head shudder.
Yeah, it would snap it back, just like taking a decent jab in a boxing match.
24 hours before their dive, which they're going to do. But in the third round, they have the possibility.
So, as you're probably hearing from the stadium announcer, these dives have been in for 24 hours, but they don't have to announce their last dive until that final round. That's when these two rounds will influence exactly who is going to dive in what order. Stephanie de Lima then, last out in round one for Canada. Brought into the world of diving by a man that we saw in action in our highlights coverage earlier today, Orlando Duque, the University of Hawaii. Acrobat by profession, started this high diving caper in 2007 and has gradually emerged on the world scene. And a little bit of a change there with that tuck position coming out, and again, not the entry that she would have been looking for.
Yeah, this is an E position. That's where you show two clear different positions. So she did the reverse somersault, including a pike shape and a tuck shape. So similar to Milana, we see the pike at the beginning. Scores, though, it's an average score, probably around maybe 7, 6 and a halves.
50.7 keeps her in touch, but it's definitely not quite getting off to the start she was looking for. And as you can see with those 2.6 tariffs that we've seen in that first round, getting into the 60s was gold dust in Barcelona today. Two rounds of these dives to come. The tariffs will go up slightly in the second round. Then we'll have a delay before the final round diving for gold.
Then we saw the two different positions. What I noticed here on the start, jump could have been better. There's the pike. Well, she forgot to touch her toes, but there the tuck is in the right position, coming around. I think without the definite jump, pike, out, tuck, you know, making it look a little sharper, just kept the scores average, reasonable entry, just collapses a little bit, not taking the impact through the quads and locking the feet hard together. The 6 and a halves for her first round dive.
Tell you the final results, the official results.
So waiting for confirmation of the lineup after the first round, but we've seen some very good diving. Rabada in particular in superb form for Germany with her arm stand dive.
Good crowd.
Yeah, it was exactly as we expected. We thought a lot of people would turn up for this. And, of course, because of the height you're diving from, because it's open air, you'll be able to witness this from way, way down the harbour. So you've got people watching all the way down. And there is the standings after the first round. And Abada has a marginal lead over the three Americans, Ginger Huber, followed by Tara Hayatia and Cecily Colton. And Stephanie De Lima, well, she won't be too happy with that opener. And Diana Tomalina gets her dive down nice and safely. We'll take a short break there.
In life and sport, dealing with the challenges ahead requires focus, concentration, and a will to succeed. The International University Sports Federation promotes sports values in tune with the academic spirit. Thousands of student-athletes from around the world participate in FISU's world-class sport competitions. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
From around the clubs building up to the return of the Premier League this weekend. All the fallout from all the games, including the wins today.
Yep, we're looking ahead to that. Plus, of course, all the news for another incident-packed day in the Premier League.
Hello, a brand new season.
Now you see it! Now you, see it!
Yes, Betty, that's the point! We don't hide our charges.
With a loan from Wonga.com, you choose how much you want to borrow and for how long, and we tell you the total cost.
You know exactly what you have to pay up front, so there are no surprises.
For a short-term loan on your terms, visit Wonga.com. Wonga.com. Straight-talking money.
Welcome back. Party atmosphere here in Port Vell. There's the crowd being entertained by our high divers today. Chance to have a quick look back at the leading dive from that first round. Anna Bader. And what a fine arm stand this was. A couple of little points, Chris, that you picked out that restricted her marks, but certainly not enough to stop her leading this competition.
Yeah, it was just a few small mistakes. But what I really liked was the press up into the handstand. It's windy up there, but showing confidence. And we knew that she's one of the ones that we thought could win this competition. So far, so good for her. Very strong balance. You can see the gymnastic background that she has. Doing a handstand on the floor is simple. Doing it this high up takes guts. Yeah, that dive scored some 8.5 points from the judges. A little mistake there, just that little pike coming off the platform. But after that, she floated around. German coaches.
Yeah, very, very popular with the crowd. That's the leading European diver at the moment, Bader. And a lot of these divers going back to the regular venues now. Superstars in the six venues on the World Series Tour. 65 marks then for Nevada, and that was good enough to lead ahead of Ginger Huber and Tara Hayatia. Have a quick look at this one.
Yeah, I just like this movement, how it flows, looks. And now, as soon as she can, she looks back, holds that really nice arch position. And the reason that she scored so high was because she held a handstand for a long time. And again, the fly through the air at this point is such a pretty shape. Very elegant and a strong entry. You drift off, not too much push off like we see from the 10 meter Olympic style diving. But look at that arch, looking around. That's a beautiful line there. Fingers out to side and pointed before she accelerates to the water.
So that was Anna Bader's effort. We go into the second round now. Remember, we've got three rounds of diving to get to our first gold medal at these championships. First two rounds decide the redraw for the dive order in the final round, when the divers will pull out the big dives. But we do move up in the tariffs for this second round. Cecily Carton away in round two. That is a much better entry from the American. And the dives go up, Chris, so 3.1 on that tariff. We see a 3.3 from Anna Bader, which could really help her. And then De Lima finishes with a 3.4.
That's right. We saw 2.6s in the first round. This is a forward double somersault, 1.5 twists, and good scores too. Up 70 points. Excellent.
127.45 for her joint first two rounds, so that means Carlton will not be diving first coming into that final round. Certainly we'll see, or wait with interest to see, what sort of tariff dive she pulls out for this final round.
Yeah, we see on the replay how the technique works. She doesn't hang around, leaning into the twist. So single twist first, then looks at the water, then Barani out, and then places the hands against the leg. Didn't really like the start. I just thought it was slightly thrown down. Untidy with the arms here before going into the Barani. Good technique on the Barani. No wobble with the arms. And a reasonable entry. So this she could score even higher on. If she could get a springier jump, finish higher out of the twist before lining up with this half twist Barani, the entry. All these dives end up with a Barani, unless it's a blind dive like the simple dives where you're doing a flying front, somersault, double or triple.
Just about got it straightened up for the entry, but very little splash coming up. So good second round dive, Cecily Carton on 127.45 after her first two rounds with one to come. So Hayatira waiting to go.
This is an interesting one. This is a back flying somersault in the top position. So half or at least half a somersault has to be done in the completely straight position before she tucks over.
All good. You can hear the wind just blowing across the mics at the top of this 20 meter platform. And for someone as slight as Tera, it really is going to blow her around there. So flying dive, we love to see these. Worked very well, but again, just going in at an off angle, so she would have felt a bit of a hit there.
Yeah, and it looked like she was scared up there, actually. You saw hardly any jump whatsoever. She jumped about 2 or 3 centimeters, and she's on a low degree of difficulty. I think it'd just be average scores because of that weakness on the takeoff. The judges will pick up that she was looking scared, and then as she picked up some, she didn't quite get around for the vertical entry.
Okay, 57.4, so slightly suppressed, but good enough for 119.80, and now we're starting to see a bit of separation between the athletes. So Carton is just under 10 points ahead.
Yeah, just a little jump back, and the tuck could have been squeezed more into the body just to show off the position. The judges are looking for the flight through the air, the position, and the lineup. So the tuck, well, just a half a tuck, really. Pretty at this point, and she's looking at the water, coming around, and you just see a slight pike as she goes in, slightly short of vertical. Water just catches her under the chin. There's the fly through the air. Does the right things with the arms to slow the rotation down, just could have pulled her arms into her body quicker to increase it at the end, just to get that dive around a bit further.
It's that shot from the actual harbour wall up to the platform that really gives you an idea of the height that the divers are coming down from. Now, leader after round one, good opener at 65 marks. Nevada comes into round two with the 3.3 tariff, which along with Tomalina and De Lima of Ukraine and Canada respectively, is the tariffs in this round.
Yeah, she loves this dive. Front triple, half twist. Not too much of a lead, so a chance for us to catch up if she doesn't get the entry.
Again, great response from the crowd to the leading European diver. Just check in with the judges, confirming safety divers are good to go. The OK sign always used. Standard call sign, really, for everybody happy if I dive now. What has Anabata got for us in round two? Beautifully done. So Anabata going along well. Two good rounds here in Barcelona from the German.
Yeah, that typical smile when she comes up. So we see, it's going to be good scores, I should think. A little short of vertical, but the pike position and the height was good.
Oh, wow. 72.6 from Bada. She is ramping it up as she goes. 137.60. Again, a 10-point lead opened up of Cecily Carlton in second place at the moment.
What can you tell us about that dive, Fernando?
There you go. And she can do even harder dives.
That'll be coming in the final round, where she will surely go in as the favourite for the gold. She'll dive last, if that is the case.
Now look at that, the pike position. She had her face right across the top of her legs. Good jump as well. His throw, face on the legs, look at the water, half turn out, and then into the water. Dive actually feels like you're in the air even longer than that. And it's a lovely feeling, just if you hit the sweet point coming out. Look at the face, very close to the shins. That's the first somersault as she's coming around. Now she digs even deeper as she comes around for the second somersault. Now she's just starting to get ready to look for the water as she comes around for the two and a half. Look, half turn, turn, and then arms by the side. Just slightly short, that's a shame. Perhaps a bit more throat at the beginning, or even longer hold onto the first part of the dive in that pipe.
Hopefully you're getting an idea now of how the divers actually do spot. Their head absolutely rock solid still, staring at the water. And through that last phase of the dive, very important you don't lose contact with where the water is. Next out then, for the USA once again, the veteran of this competition at 38 years of age, Ginger Huber, really enjoying herself. I wonder how long she will continue her high diving career. Surely she'll give it a few seasons into the new World Series. Second at the moment, behind Bada after that first round, but only 3.1 on the tariff. Yeah, it's a nice dive. It's a good entry from Huber.
Yeah, I like that. Front double, 1.5 twists. Good twist action. I like the way that Ginger goes into the twist. Her arms wrapped close to the body, smooth twist for the first somersault.
Well, I reckon that was one of the dives of the day, Chris. I think we're going to see something big here. Oh, yes, 79.1. 141.45 puts Ginger Huber into the lead. I don't think we thought we would see Anabata surpassed in this round, but Ginger Huber has pulled one out of the top drawer there. The American leads.
I think if you take it on entry alone, she was completely vertical, but the actual technique of the dive was good too. Some we've seen get good entries, but not a good start. Here, into the one twist, and then the pike down. And from this angle, you can see how high she finishes it. Boy, that was beautiful. She finished that dive about 18 meters high. Coming around, does the Brani at about 10 meters, and a good drop into the water. That was a nice flying feeling, and the whole thing flowed right from the beginning.
Huber leads. Two divers to come in the second round here in Barcelona. Live coverage of the Women's High Dive World Championship Final. Six divers involved. But as you've probably already worked out, fair bit of time between each diver. Not just because it takes a little while longer to come down from 20 metres, but the divers have to just set themselves up and make sure they are ready to go. Diana Tomalina then, good start from her. Got it down safely, but well below the 50 points. But this is a huge ask for her in this second round, Chris.
Yeah, same dive as Anna Bada did in the first round, and she got 65 points on this. We can see if she does the same style. It's a back arm stand, 1.5 somersaults in the straight position. The toughest part, really, is getting up. It's psychologically difficult to be backwards and then go up into your handstand. Signal to the safety divers that they're all clear.
She looks nervous to me. Ginger Huber leads from Anna Bader. So USA, Germany, and then it's USA again with Cecily Carlton in third. Already seen this dive perform very well by the German. Here's the first demand. So slightly different way into the arm stand. Through the tricky phase, she's just about got it there, but off early. But controls it. Very well done from Tomalina. Well, we know that she's had problems in training. We know she's had a couple of very heavy hits on diving this week, but that one, very well done.
Yeah, good start. I think she should have held the handstand a little longer, but it's whipping around the wind up there. But this is certainly a good entry. I'm sure the judges will give her a good score. Again, just the arms a little bit moving around on the dive, but they've got the vertical entry. Be interested to see how they score it.
Oh, they've scored it well. Look at that, 74.3. Just shows you how quickly the divers can recover in the leaderboard. And it just shows you when they come with their big dives in the last round, just how much movement they can make for a score that goes over 100 if they can get there.
Yeah, the 3.3 definitely helped to move up the ranks. She's got a hard coach, kept pushing her and pushing her throughout the week, and she's got better and better.
Paying off at the moment, certainly.
So pushing up through the shoulders, drifting off the board, looking back. Good flight position. Yeah, just a wobble there. Actually, that has got really good. Each day, she's been here practicing harder than just about anybody. Arch, looking back, good side to the water. High finish there. Yeah, just the arms a little bit untidy.
Body tension awesome, and just that slight pike out. That's a very good dive indeed from the Ukraine diver.
Now, we had a better layout position, I think, with Anna Bader, but it was a good vertical entry there.
So Tomalina will have a bit of confidence to take into the third and final round. Next up, the last of our six, Stephanie De Lima of Canada. The 25-year-old who didn't look at her best in that first round, unfortunately. So needs to find something with this second round just to set things up for a place on the podium.
Oh, yeah, this is the hardest dive we're going to see in this round, 3.4. It's a back double with double twists.
Now, if she can push 80s, high 80s, then she will certainly recover her position on the leaderboard.
Yeah, 8 will give her that.
Again, just a little tentative off the platform, but after that, the dive really flowed for the Canadian.
A reasonable entry. I'm just saying, it's just that snap off the board could just be a bit quicker.
His former coach, Cesar Henderson. Yeah. At university and international level, but still works with her in a high dive capacity.
Make it up into the 70s. Oh, she has.
71.4. So Stephanie De Lima on track, but not quite the sort of area she wanted to be with that big tariff dive.
I think with the crowds there and the adrenaline flowing, you just perform a bit better. It is near perfect conditions. In practice, everybody was looking just a little ropey. But these are true competitors, used to the high diving. Not as experienced as the men, but you can see technique is good. 1.5 twists. pulling in, now piking out, now looking at the water, spotting the water, slow Barani out, pike, and then line up at the end. Good control all the way throughout. Reasonable technique, just need to be more confident on the jump. And there's the final entry in the water. Maybe just a hair piked. Again, you catch the water on your face as you're going in. But you'll be pleased with 70 points.
Yes, 122-10, good enough for fourth position at the moment. Just a little over 5 points behind Cecily Carlton. So everything can change with the big tariff final dives. That's when you'll see some potentially some big movement on this leaderboard.
Wow, she could add another twist to that, which she may do in the final.
Yes, we will see. That's when the multiple spins, multiple twists come into the equation. So that's how things stand. Great round for Ginger Huber of the USA. What a phenomenal dive from her to get past Anna Bader of Germany, the six-time European champion, in second at the moment. Cecily Carlton hanging on to that bronze medal spot. And remember, these are the first medals that we will see in the history of FINA World Championship high diving. And if you can take that first ever gold, well, that's something that goes on the CV and stays in perpetuity. We'll take a short break there.
The country that travels within you.
Victor!
Morris, how did you get in here?
When you're a wag, Vic, doors just open. Oops. Before they clock I'm a geezer, give us your best odds on the match.
Morris, if you want our best odds, just go on to betvictor.com. We had the best odds most often on the Premier League last season.
For a free £25 bet, talk to Victor. Live the World Swimming Championships with EDF, proud partner of swimming.
Welcome back. Oh, what a fantastic start to our coverage here in Barcelona from the first ever FINA High Diving World Championship Finals. Women will decide the medals today. At the moment, it is USA that lead, looking for another medal, along with David Budia's medal from the pool. But let's take a look back at what happened in the men's competition as the women sort out which dives they wish to do in their final round of competition. That's when the tariffs will just sneak up a little bit. But this is what happened for the men. Very good diver in Silchenko, emerging on the world scene. And the 29-year-old Russian, who's on record as saying, "Russians are scared of nothing. We chase bears off." So going off 27 meters into the harbor here at Port Vale in Barcelona. Pretty straightforward for this young man.
That was his inward flying. Somersault in the pipe position where he picked up the tens. Look at that, 121 points.
It's phenomenal, isn't it? But as these tariffs increase, three more rounds of diving to go still for the men, we are going to see some quite unbelievable dives as we go up towards 6 and 6.1 on the degree of difficulty, Chris.
See the fly through the air. That is a great feeling. You jump, you come out into a swan position, we used to call it many years ago. Look at that. Couldn't be straighter. And he just flies around, three quarters of a somersault, and then he does his pike. It's a blind dive. It carries more degree of difficulty. He can't see the water. He has to feel where it is. Great potential for hurting yourself. As we're saying, the divers, the cliff divers, high divers, have to use their eyes, spot the water from above to get their entry. But this, he does this the best of all the divers, the blind inward flying somersault pike.
Chris Snow, my co-commentator, typical of a diver, I can tell you that when they say it's potential to hurt themselves, they always giggle. But it is a different mindset, isn't it, for divers in general, but for the high divers, for the cliff divers, they really are a different breed.
They certainly are. It's extreme sport where you can actually get killed, and everything is about being safe. The sports director, Nikki Stajkovic, checks that the divers are safe. No one can enter this competition unless they prove themselves beforehand. And here's another dive that went really well.
Beautiful from Paradis of Mexico, and that pushed him up the leaderboard.
Yeah, this was nines. It was a front triple with half twist. Dive is done in two parts. They think of the front 2.5 somersaults and then spot the water and then do the Barani out. And what I particularly liked about this was the pike position, and the finish was so high before going into the somersault half twist at the end.
Not quite the 121 marks that we saw from Silchenko, but Jonathan Paradis doing himself a lot of favours in that second round. And I think so much talk coming into this competition about, would it be Duquet, would it be Gary Hunt? And we always thought there was that opportunity for a new name to get in amongst it. And, well, Paradis and Silchenko certainly look to be those candidates at the moment.
Yeah, look how good this is. Face across the legs, double finished at about just 2 meters under the platform. That means he's got 25 meters to fly. And that's why it was so good.
And this is the man they are chasing, the undisputed king of high diving and cliff diving, Orlando Duque, with that phenomenal number of World Series titles and championship titles to his name. And Chris, if the head-to-head here in Barcelona was supposed to be between he and the current champion, Gary Hunt, then Duque has taken the first two rounds comfortably.
Yeah, you can't rule him out because of his experience. He knows also how to please the crowd. He's up there, he's waving to everybody before he goes, and then you can just see tunnel vision. He's like, there's nothing else. It could be windy. He's been in all sort of conditions and gets that brilliant score. Front triple, half twist. He can match anybody on it.
Big smile from the Colombian, now based in Hawaii.
And you can see, as he goes into this, there's the jump. First somersault, pulls in. Second somersault, come around. Arms out, now looks to the water. Now you have the half turn. Now he's starting to judge it with his arms. And then that pike was instrumental to getting him around. He's always in control. Good eye spot. Good Barani to finish. And that's the film from above as well. It's so high.
Okay, 36-year-old. Not defying gravity, but certainly defying the age barrier to go into the final day of competition for the men tomorrow. Their last three rounds of diving as the leader. But Chris will see some phenomenal degree of difficulty, and that's when Gary Hunt of Great Britain will hope to make his move.
Certainly will. And talking to Blake Aldridge for Great Britain. Also is going to try out some big dives. Armstand, back twister should be pretty tough and hard to beat.
We'll take a break there. We'll be back with the remainder of the women's competition. Stay with us.
Holidays?
No.
Business?
No.
Friends?
No.
Why are you so far away from home?
I have no idea.
Is this the Somersby?
This is it. This is what all the excitement's about.
Single core, dual core.
Move towards the mouth and interface.
Full of great content.
And you've downloaded.
I've downloaded?
One click. Boom. You're connected. And works perfectly in direct sunlight.
Somersby Cider. Less apps, more apples.
Welcome back, crowd getting ready to see another gold medal at this FINA World Aquatic Championships. That's our list, or our dive order, for the third and final round for the women. Tomalita followed by Hayatera, and it's De Lima, Carlton, Bada and Huber. Looks to me like it's between Cuba and Bader for the gold medal, but we will see. Things do change in the final round, and Chris, we've got a chance to have a little look down the dive list for this last round. Any idea on the kind of tariffs that we are going to move to?
Well, the hardest dive we're going to see is a 3.4, and that is a back arm stand double with double twists. We also have a back double pipe position. Three of the divers are doing twists, others are just doing somersault rotating, but there's nothing over 3.4, and that's Anna Bader of Germany. We'll see higher degree of difficulty in the men's, but of course, don't forget the girls or the women are only just going off 20 meters.
Yeah,
so they only have so much time.
Yes, with very much a smile on our face, it is still way, way up there. But I think what's happening here is that they're trying to keep it within certain realms, and they don't want to make a mistake. They really are focused on this medal. Third and final round then of dives before we see the first ever FINA World Championship high diving gold medal given out. At the moment, it is Ginger Hooper of the USA that leads, just ahead of Anna Bader, but really not much separating those two. It'll be Diana Tomalina of Ukraine to get things underway. Fantastic second round arm stand dive.
Oh, she's wobbled. That was the wind. I think that'll allow that. Sometimes that would be taken as a 2-point deduction, but she put her hand just out to the side to the referee and said, that was the wind that put me off.
Good thinking from the Ukraine diver. She was in trouble. She was in trouble all the way through that dive, and she will have taken a bit of a hit there.
Oh, she's okay, though. Well, this is a tough one to do, and my choice. So it starts off as a back 1.5. Well, she doesn't look so happy now, does she? She took that on the back part of her body.
Yeah, that's knocked the wind out of her. Well, let's see what the judges go with on this one. I think we're going to see quite a pause before the judges actually give the marks out in this third and final round, because there's so much dive to sort out with some of these, but that isn't going to score well.
No, it won't score well because of the tuck after the pike. Here's the back 1.5 pike, then you come out. Now she looks at the water, then she bends her legs. She wasn't allowed to do that. She can bend at the hips, but not at the knees. That's not a true position. And because she's done that, she's over-rotated. So they're going to score her right down for it. And this anything part of the vertical, oh, that's going to be so painful. There, shouldn't have bent the legs, just bent at the hips. And it picks up speed at the end. And she took a whack on her back.
Yeah, as soon as those knees bent, she was in trouble. Still waiting for confirmation. There it is, 36.8. Well, Tomalina gets through her first ever World Championships safely. I can tell you, after some of the reports we had back from training, it was not expected. We thought she might have one poor dive, but just about got through. So Tomalina is done, mixed out. It is the American. Tarahara Tira of the USA, 119.80 marks, but she looked just a little nervous before her second round dive, Chris, and it really was quite a tense affair. What she got for us in this round?
Well, this is going to be a reverse somersault, and she can do a pike and a tuck. Now, typically, we'll see the pike at the beginning, then out and tuck around, or she could tuck, come out, and then pike around. We'll see.
So look for those two defined movements within the one dive. This is what the diver from the USA is known for. So she was allowed to make those bends. She's got it right, and that's the best entry that we've seen so far in this third round.
That's it. So reverse is when you stand with your back to the diving board and your front to the water. Once you take off, you rotate back towards the board. Nobody knows what a reverse is. So this is a typical way to do the dive. Jump, pike. I think I only score around 6.5 sevens, just because the pike could have been deeper. And again, the tuck, when she does the tuck, it's just a little bit open on the tuck. Pike, heads up a bit too much there. Good entry, though. That's vertical. So no pain. as she goes through the water. Just the tuck open. She spots in the water. She feels good on the rotation. She feels in control. Using the arm just to slow the dive down a fraction.
Yeah, no pain, but unfortunately no gain, I'm afraid, for Tara, 57.4. Third and final round for the women's high dive competition here in Barcelona. De Lima next for Canada. It is Tira of the USA that leads on 177.20. A twister then for De Lima from Canada to finish. She goes up to 3.1 on the degree of difficulty. Quite interesting that she's chosen a lesser degree of difficulty for this final round, but obviously came here with a plan. And he's looking for a place on the podium in her shootout, really, with Cecily Carlton, who's currently in third position.
That's right. Used a 3.4. I think she was hoping to get a better position by using the higher degree of difficulty earlier. This is a forward double somersault, 1.5 twists. We'll see the twist first, or at least we'll see the single twist first, and we'll see a half twist to finish.
It's long. Hold from De Lima as she just gets the focus right. The DJ as well, the announcer, playing a bit of music between the dives as well before he announces. And gotta be ready to go, gotta be ready in your mind. You must not dive until you are ready to dive. I know that sounds like a very simple thing to say, but how many times have we done sport and played a shot before we were ready to play it? Now just imagine doing that, but still with 20 meters to drop before you hit what is a very hard object, being the water. Away we go. And that's done well. So De Lima with a good strong finish, and that's at least going to ask a question of Cecily Carlton, who goes next.
Yeah, she was in fourth place, so has a chance of medal, but I just don't think it's going to be good enough. All the movements just sort of flow into each other. So with the run-up, one twist, here we go, one twist, look, half twist out, feet a little untidy, slightly short of vertical, springy jump, just here, feet came apart, and then together again.
Can she take over from Hayatira of the USA in top spot? That's the first question. If she can, then she has a shot at a place on the podium.
Yeah, just push the dive forward a fraction, seeing it from that angle as well. Knees could be locked out a bit more, and the arms pressed against the body, and more upright position going through the water. This point, she's in control, just her feet a little bit loose. Arms slightly out of sync. There's an average double with 1.5 twists. Just checking that last little piece. Just a little pipe going through the water.
So 60.5, she does take over in top spot, 182.55. And De Lima sets a mark for Canada, but well, we know that. She certainly has the tariff to get past De Lima. That's not an issue. But this one, a very difficult dive again with this wind blowing across. That's going to ask a few questions here of Cecily.
At least she doesn't have an arm stand, so that's good.
Yes, look for the positives. So, currently laying in bronze medal position, Chris, what has Cecily got for us?
She's got a front triple with half twist. It's in the pike position. I only see the twist at the end, just signaling to the safety divers. It's all clear, and she's opting to do it in the standing position. Doesn't hang around.
She really doesn't, and that is a superb entry, and surely that will be enough to put Carlton on the podium.
Yeah, I think she's going to score well. She pops up really quick because she knew she landed that entry, but she doesn't hang around. Just as we're ready to talk about it, she was off.
Needs to go past 182.55 to move into that first position.
That could even go into 80s. It was so good.
Yes, it does. Good call, Chris. 84.2. 211.60. The score to beat. So that's the clubhouse lead. And Cecily Carlton has guaranteed herself a medal at this FINA World Championships, and that is something to treasure. The first ever medals handed out for high diving by FINA.
That's quite a score there. And just seeing, look at that throw. Excellent. Good pike position. A bit early into the Barani, but again, they're only off 20 metres, not 27 metres, so you can't hang around. Dropping like a stone. Out, half twist. She judged it perfectly. I think she was comfortable in the start, the throw. And here you can see there's no panic, no bending the knees, not bending your arms, not waving around. And that impressed the judges. She was in control right from the start.
Very good work. Cecily Carlton leads in Barcelona. Two dives to come here at Port Vell. And then we will know which diver will be taking home the first ever FINA World Championship high diving gold medal in the history of the sport. Will it be this lady, Anna Bader of Germany? Will it be the woman that leads at the moment? Many people's sentimental favourite, at least, 38-year-old Ginger Huber from the USA, who dives last. So, final round then for Anna Bader. And at 3.4, it's a big tariff on this dive.
Yeah, and she can do it. This is a back double, one and a half, or double twist, in fact, at 3.4. She only needs to go 7.5 on average to go ahead of Colton.
Carlton leads for the USA on 211.60. Anna Bader flying the flag for Germany and Europe here in Spain. Yeah, good entry and a reasonable dive. I think it's going to be tight, but she can do it.
Yeah, it may be tight. I just think she could have locked out more in the end. The jump into the one and a half twist was good. Just a bit wobbly though coming out, and that could hurt her. So technique at the start was good. It's just, I don't know whether it was just vertical enough.
Oh dear. Well, 66.3. You said sevens, Chris. She's come up with 6.5s, and a very disappointed Anna Bader swims to the side. And despite the smile from the German, you can't get away from the fact that she is upset with that and couldn't quite bring it home for Germany here. It's going to be a medal for Anna Bader. Moves into second position ahead of De Lima. But whether it is a silver or a bronze will come down to Ginger Huber. A good dive, but clearly the judge is picking up enough to work with.
Yeah, it was actually, I just saw the problem. She jumps here. This is good. One and a half twist out. But then she just doesn't realize, as she comes around, the elbow pulls around the side, and rather than the arm come up for a smoother Barani out of that second part of the dive, you see the arms are bent, she's unsure about the feel, that rotation, and then she just leaves the dive slightly short of vertical. Here, arms are bent, oh, where should I be? And never quite definite on the last pipe. Good start, excellent technique into the first one and a half twist. Finishes the one and a half twist just about at board level. Great jump into the dive. But from there on, it wasn't definite enough. She's coming around. This bit is fine. But needs to have a better look at the water before the Barani commences.
Yes, goes in. Face looking down at the water and a lot of splash thrown up. It wasn't to be, I'm afraid, for Anna Bader. The disappointment clear. Very close-knit community, the high divers. So they will all be congratulating each other, but clearly this medal means a lot. And at the moment, Cecily Carlton leads, Anna Bader in second, Stephanie De Lima in third, Ginger, but this woman Huber can take it away from everybody, Ginger Huber.
Yeah, this is a blind dive, so it's 2.9. It's a front somersault with a fly in the middle of it, and it's tuck. And she's going to have to go over an average of 8. This is so tricky. And we've seen multiple somersaults, multiple twists, but as a blind entry dive, this is actually harder. And it takes a little bit of luck as well.
Oh, she's got it in. It's going to come down to the judges here. 211.60 to beat from that fantastic final round dive of Cecily Carlton. Is it good enough from Ginger Hoover?
Well, I'm not so sure. That final again is the final bit of the out. I like the fly, but then did she actually get in straight enough? I'm not so sure.
Judges say no. 65.3. Well, it would have been wonderful if the veteran diver could have taken the medal, but Ginger Hoover will not go home with gold. She's going to have to settle for silver from this first FINA World Championships. And the diver that so many people were tipping for gold at the start of this week, Cecily Carlton, has come up with the goods for the USA.
That's great. First and second. Actually, it's quite interesting. Ginger hadn't actually gone off the 20-meter platform until today. She'd done all of her lead-ups, and we're thinking, is there something wrong? There must be a problem. She never let on, and her coach, who is also her husband, Chris, didn't let on either. So it was a good result for her to get a second.
So marvellous stuff from Ginger Hoover. Silver medal to take back to SeaWorld in San Diego, where she works and heads up all of the show programs. And look at that. As one plane departs Barcelona, another flyer arrives in the harbour. Love it.
Just looking at the tuck position, that was a fantastic tuck. And she probably did the right choice of dives, and it has been close at the end. But USA 1-2.
Oh, Cecily Carlton saved her best till last. It really was a wonderful final round dive. And the US dive program can add two more medals to the one that David Badia managed to secure for them. And that means that this World Championships has been good work. So a gold medal from Carlton. It's Hoover that takes silver, making it 1-2 for the USA. And Abada of Germany having to settle for bronze. Didn't quite come up with the goods in that final round. So there we go, Chris. Enjoy that first championship medal in the high diving.
It's fantastic, and it's things to come, I think.
Yes, many, many more years to come, we hope, for the high divers in FINA sense. Men's 27-metre final, then, is coming up tomorrow. Three rounds of diving still to go for the men before we see if Duque can hang on to that gold medal spot. Will Gary Hunt hunt him down? Or is it going to be another name at the top of the leaderboard? We will see. So a great final over. First of the high diving finals. We've got the men's to come tomorrow, but we're going off next to live coverage of Croatia, Australia in the water polo. Paul, stay with us for that here on Eurosport. But here in Barcelona, it's cuddles and hugs all round for Cecily as she takes the first gold medal. Carlton is the first high diving FINA world champion.